Mother Nature is beautiful, but she's also a harbinger of death and destruction with the power to level a city in minutes. Tornadoes can have winds of over 200 miles an hour and be over 2 miles wide. So who in their right mind would not only get close to one, but chase it? I mean, beyond the Instagram picture and a cheap thrill, why do they do it? Climate change has been a hot topic for a while now. Global temperatures have been consistently on the rise. Tornadoes, while less frequent, are more severe, making it even more important for us to understand our weather phenomena. In the Midwest's only swing state, organizations like the Iowa Storm Chasing Network are learning as much as they can to protect their community.
The Iowa Storm Chasing Network is a team of guys that goes out and storm chases, provides us weather information through social media.
They leverage different social platforms to connect in real time with people around the country. Who would have thought? Social media, the real community organizer.
We're going to hopefully chase some storms this week. There's a potential for severe weather on Tuesday, Wednesday, and maybe Thursday. We'll see what happens. But Tuesday looks like Kansas, Oklahoma, maybe Southwest Iowa. We'll keep an eye on it. You know, radars can only show so much, and then that's in the upper levels of the atmosphere. But we're at the ground level. It can show you what's happening underneath that cloud that the radar can't pick up.
So what is a tornado?
A tornado basically is nature's stop valve. When there's so much energy, nature can't do anything with it. It has to spin it up and transfer that energy as rapidly as possible from the surface up into the upper atmosphere.
Okay, I think I get it now. But the devastation these wind cyclones can create is extreme, which leads me to this pressing question.
Is Mother Nature upset about the presidential election?
I think everybody's upset about the presidential election.
Climate change is such a politicized issue. You literally get a front row seat of the environment all the time. Do you see something happening that's changing in the environment?
I think we're seeing some changes, and I think a lot of people see them, but nobody really knows how to categorize them. I also think, you know, it's only been the last 20 or 30 years that we've had the scientific, you know, instrumentation able to measure this on a large scale. But something's going wonky here.
Even though new technology exists, these chasers drive thousands and thousands of miles to ensure they're on the scene when they need to be. That's a lot of gas station food, and it's this dedication and determination that our public deserves.
National Weather Service just issued a tornado watch for the day.
Oh boy, here we go.
Right now, just nothing's happening, but we can see on the maps that there's storms in their infant stages that are starting to, as Todd says, fire off. Imagine a really dark rain cloud that is now looks like it's coming down to the surface, and then there's a diagonal cloud that's coming in and feeding it energy, and it's making it more angry.
Tornadoes are rare. They don't always happen. But observing and documenting intense weather is vital for the Iowa Storm Chasing Network. Their work helps protect not just themselves, but everyone.
Let's get out of here.
Let's go, Jimmy. Well, we didn't see a tornado, but we did learn a few things, some surprisingly political things. That the most political act you can do is to help your community. The Iowa Storm Chasing Network is just a small group of citizens engaging in a public service that can save lives. In an age when you can't trust everything you read, these are the guys that are bringing you the raw truth. Truth in an election year is hard to come by, but with just a little bit of truth, we can start to create the future that we want as a country.